This video lecture is related to RNA processing. It's a collective term that refers to several kinds of modification that takes place in a primary transcript RNA. Look at this image. You can able to understand the importance of the RNA processing there in the organisms. As our molecular biology is related with the prokaryotic molecular biology, I am insisting more points related to the prokaryotes. So transcriptionally, some sort of differences are existing between a normal DNA and a DNA of the rRNA molecule. You all aware that any kind of a molecule in a living organism need to be coded by the genes, whether it's an enzyme or a RNA or a protein. Everything need to be coded by a gene. So in this aspect, there is a small difference existing between the normal DNA and the DNA of the rRNA molecule. So if you look at into the transcriptional of normal DNA, DNA will be converted into mRNA. From the mRNA, it will be converted into protein. So the first step is the transcription. And the second step is referred as a translation there in the molecular biology. In this first step of the mRNA formation also, some small differences were existing between the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. See, look at this diagram. The left side one is a prokaryote. From the DNA, an mRNA molecule is transcribed. That mRNA molecule will be immediately translated there in the prokaryotic organisms. When we look at into the eukaryotic organism, the DNA, when it is getting transcribed, it will be converted only as a pre-mRNA. Formation of pre-mRNA is an important feature or unique feature of the eukaryotic organism. This pre-mRNA found to possess intron and exons. Introns are intervening sequences, exons are coding sequences. So this pre-mRNA need to be spliced, meaning some segments of the gene need to be removed. That is, intron portion is removed and exons are united together, and that forms a final mRNA molecule that will be further subjected for the translation process. So this is a molecular level differences existing between prokaryotes and eukaryotes in the step of transcription. Apart from that, transcriptional differences were found to exist between normal DNA and rRNA's DNA. These differences are present both in eukaryotes as well as the prokaryotes. When you look at into normal DNA, from DNA, mRNA will be formed, from there protein will be formed. However, when you go into the DNA of rRNA, it is also referred as non-coding RNAs. This process is referred as transcribing the non-coding RNAs. So when a non-coding RNA is transcribed in a prokaryote or in a eukaryote, that results in the formation of rRNA or tRNA molecule. So this image shows the structure of the tRNA and rRNA. tRNA and rRNA in a primary structure, they will be present as a linear molecule. However, complementary bases present there will help in a double-stranded like formation, which is referred as a secondary structure. So you all already aware that the RNA can able to form a lot of secondary structures, that is in a stem and loop configuration. So this kind of a secondary structures are commonly exist there in the nature for tRNA molecule and for rRNA molecule. So when a rRNA's DNA is getting transcribed, that is, they are referred as a non-coding RNAs, they forms into rRNA and tRNA. The rRNA is playing a structural component role there in the ribosomes. That has been shown there in the image. And then the tRNA is the one which transports the amino acid during the process of translation. Thus, the RNA processing refers to a collective term that best describes about the modification or alterations that to the primary transcript. What are the types of alteration can able to happen? It is of three kinds. One is removal of nucleotides, both by action of exonucleases and endonucleases. Second one is addition of certain nucleotides that to the 5' or 3' ends of the primary transcripts or their cleavage products. For example, during a 5' capping, 7 methyl guanosine is being added there. That particular nucleotide has been added there, and during a 3' poly A tail addition, adenine has been added there to the tail portion there in the eukaryotic RNAs. Sometimes the nucleotide itself will be modified on either the base or in the sugar moiety. So this different kind of modification we will look at detail in the further course of this lecture. Thus, after the process of transcription, both the tRNA and rRNA are processed in the prokaryote as well as in the eukaryotic organism. Say, in the eukaryotic rRNA, they are processed, that is trimmed, chemically modified from large precursor rRNA to a mature functional role performing RNAs. These precursor RNA contain in their sequence the information that are necessary for their function in the cell. So, both prokaryote and eukaryotes, ribosomal and transfer RNAs undergoes a lot of modifications. Say, in the pre-rRNA, that is the ribosomal RNAs, the pre-rRNA that in turn makes the ribosomal RNA is cleaved and trimmed to make into multiple shorter mature rRNA molecules. Whereas in tRNA, the pre-tRNAs, that is transfer RNAs, are trimmed some bases within the transcript are chemically modified. Say, in the 3' end of the tRNA molecule, which is not coded by a tRNA genes, however, it is enzymatically added with the help of certain special enzyme. Now, we look at the prokaryotic rRNA and tRNA processing. Other than mRNA, most of the RNAs of the cells are transcribed as a precursor RNAs, that is the tRNA and rRNA. They have to be further processed to obtain into a functional forms. That is, they need to be cleaved, they need to be modified, and then only a final functional form of tRNA or rRNA will be obtained. Ribosomal RNAs are synthesized by polymerase 1 and polymerase 3 as a large precursor molecule. These molecules are synthesized and subjected to various kind of processing such as methylations and pseudo-uridylation of bases at specific sites, mainly to ensure the secondary structural conformations there on the molecule. Then cleaving the precursor transcript at a specific position to obtain a functional rRNA and tRNA molecule. Now we look at a few points related to what are the enzymes and how it is taking up a processing there in the prokaryote and also in the eukaryote. I have taken the two segments. One is the rRNA processing, another one is the tRNA processing. So in both this molecule, a pre-rRNA or a pre-tRNA is processed and finally converted into a functional rRNA or tRNA molecule. The processing of rRNA involves cleavage, methylation of the ribose residues and formation of the pseudouridine. But the tRNAs of both prokaryotes and eukaryotes are modified by RNase-P ribosome, that is the type of enzyme involved in the processing of the tRNA of both eukaryotes and prokaryotes. The third point, the rRNA processing of pre-transcript modifications is mediated by ribonucleoprotein complexes called as RNase-3 in the prokaryote, but small ribonucleoprotein particles which are called as a SNORNPs are playing a major role there in the eukaryotes. Regarding tRNA processing, the 5' as well as 3' end of the tRNA molecules are modified and the base modification in certain characteristic positions of the tRNA molecule is also affected. For example, uridine can be modified into pseudouridine. A guanosine base can be modified into inosine there in a tRNA molecule. So these are all certain characteristic processing things that takes place both in the rRNA as well as in the tRNA molecules.
Look at this image. This image shows how a rRNA as well as tRNA are processed there in a prokaryotic organism from a primary transcript. So primary transcript is the one which formed of pre-16S rRNA, pre-tRNA, pre-23S rRNA, pre-5S rRNA, pre-tRNA. So it found to have both rRNA as well as tRNA together. So it need to be acted upon by the RNase enzyme, especially that RNase 3. So by the action of this RNase, finally you are getting a functional rRNA as well as tRNA molecule. The tRNA and how it is formed are all we will see separately. We will look at the points related to now the rRNA. So rRNA components include 16S rRNA, 23S rRNA, 5S rRNA. So all these things makes about the ribosomal structural component. So this is the 70S ribosome of the prokaryote. It has the two component, 50S and 30S. If you look at the 16S, it forms as a component of 30S, whereas the other two, 23S and 5S, are joining there into the 50S component of the ribosomes. Both these things unite together and forms into a functional 70S ribosome. Now we look at the modifications there in the tRNA molecule. Both in the tRNA of a prokaryote as well as a eukaryote are all modified by the following enzymes. First one is a RNase P ribosome. This is a ribosome enzyme is involved in cutting the 5' end there of the pre-tRNA molecule to form into a functional tRNA. So in this pre-tRNA, again in the 3' end, a conventional proteinase RNase similar to that of the RNase 3 what we have seen in the ribosomal RNA processing is involved there in processing the 3' end of the tRNA. It also adds a CCA basis there to the 3' end. So these are all certain actions that have been created by the enzymes there in the pre-tRNA molecule to form into a functional tRNA. The third important component that takes place there in the tRNA is the modification in the bases. So you can able to look at these are the following bases that have been present there in the living organism. Say uridine and guanosine. Uridine is the one which is modified into dihydrouridine, ribothymidine and pseudouridine. Like that, guanosine is modified into inosine as well as methyl guanosine. So these modified forms are those that have been present there in the tRNA molecule. You can able to see a lot of modified bases that have been added there, and the positions are all is being indicated. Methyl guanosine, dihydrouridine, then you can able to see a inosine. These are all the positions of the inosine. You can able to see the position of pseudouridine. These are all pseudouridine. So like that, the normal bases that have been present there in the primary transcript are all now modified in the final form of the tRNA molecule. So these are all the various modifications that takes place in the tRNA and makes it into a functional tRNA molecule.